So friends, in our previous tutorial, we actually discussed about the implementation of an undirected graph through adjacency list. So in this tutorial, we will code that implementation into Eclipse. So here I have created one class by name graph having a main method. So here in the graph class, we'll first create an array of linked list. We'll import the linked list from java.util. We'll also create an integer variable and we'll name it as v. So this integer variable will be having a value of number of vertices in the graph. So it represents number of vertices. And similarly, we'll create one more integer variable and we'll name it as e. So this integer variable will be having a value of number of edges in graph. We'll also create one constructor and to this constructor we'll pass the number of vertices the graph can have. So we'll give this integer a name as nodes. So here what we can do is, as v represents the number of vertices in a graph, so we'll simply assign the value of nodes to it. And as this graph is getting initialized, so the value of e will be 0 because currently there are no edges. And finally we'll create an instance of array of linked list. So this dot adj equals new linked list and we'll pass the value of nodes to it. So after creating an instance of array of linked list, currently each and every index of this array will point to null because the linked list has not been initialized. So we'll provide a for loop and we will iterate over each and every vertex and we'll create a separate linked list for each and every index of the array. So adj of v . So friend, in this for loop we are iterating over each and every vertex, and as we have created this array of linked list, therefore we need to initialize a linked list for each and every index. Moving ahead, we'll create a method as addEdge. So this method takes in a two value. Let's say we give the name to as u and v. So by calling this addEdge method, what we are doing is we are creating an edge between u and v. Friends, in our previous tutorial we saw that in order to create an edge between u and v, we have to provide the value of v into the linked list of u, and similarly we have to provide a value of u into a linked list of v. So here what we do is, into the linked list of u, we add the value v. And similarly, into the linked list of v, we add value u. And finally, we increment the value of e by 1 because it signifies that an edge has been placed between u and v. Therefore, we are incrementing the e by 1. So friends, in the main method, we'll first initialize the graph with the number of nodes. So friends, in our previous tutorial we saw an undirected graph which had 4 nodes. So we'll initialize this graph with 4 vertices. So we provide a value as 4 and then we'll add an edge from 0 to 1 and then from 1 to 2, then from 2 to 3, and finally from 3 to 0. So friends, here we have created one graph of four nodes and we have added four edges. So friend, in order to test its working, I will create one method as toString. So friend, this method will return back as a string representation of this graph. So in the first step, I will be creating a string builder. So to this string builder, first I will append vertices. And edges. And then we'll provide a for loop and we'll simply iterate over each and every vertex. So here to string builder we'll append v. So friends, here in the for loop, we are getting each and every value of vertex. So friends, as we are looping over each and every vertex, we have the vertex value. We'll provide one more for loop, which will bring back the linked list associated with that vertex and we'll iterate over it and print its content. So here we'll provide one more for loop. So in order to iterate over a linked list associated with a particular vertex, what we do is we simply pass the value of that vertex and we'll get the linked list associated with it. So here if I take an example, then we have added an edge from 0 to 1 and there is one edge from 3 to 0. Therefore when we call the linked list associated with vertex 0, we'll get the two values, one is the value 1 and one is the value 3, because those two values are there in the linked list. So in this for loop, we'll simply append the value present in the linked list for that particular vertex. And finally, we'll append one line break. And we simply return the string representation of this string builder. So friends, in our main method, we'll now sys out the value of g and we'll run this code. So friend, here you can see the graph has four vertices and four edges. Because we have initialized the graph with 4 vertex, therefore the value of v is 4, which is the number of vertex. And as we have added 4 edges, we are getting the value of the number of edges as 4. And here in the toString representation of it, what we are doing is, we are iterating over each and every vertex, that is from 0, 1, 2 and 3. And here you can see that there is an edge from 0 to 1. And 0 to 3. Therefore, from the vertex 0, there is an edge to 1 and there is an edge to 3. And similarly, from vertex 3, there is an edge to 2 and there is an edge to 0. There is an edge between 2 and 3 and 3 and 0. So into the linked list of this third index, there are values 2 and 0, which represent that there is an edge between 3 and 2 and 3 and 0. So friend, this is how we actually represent a graph through an array of linked list. I hope you like this video. Thanks, have a nice day.